Finally escaped the watchful gaze of your keepers, have we? Don't react. You'll only draw attention to yourself. Just carry on as you are and listen. After you left with the Garlean lad, Lucia bade a few of our scouts follow you at a discreet distance. We observed you being led into the station, but decided against venturing inside. When you emerged sometime later, and we saw that the twins were sporting Magitek collars, it was clear what had taken place. Now, as quietly as you can, tell me everything. The Legatus himself, eh? Now there's a surprise. This is also the first I've heard of a plan to join forces with the Tenth and storm the Tower of Babel. An interesting development. And perhaps the opportunity we've been waiting for. Our comrades back at the camp also received some rather promising news, but it's still too early to get our hopes up. For now, keeping yourselves out of harm's way comes before all else. Whatever demands the Garleans make, indulge them. With luck, this will all be over soon. Until then.
They had not gone far.
We searched high and low, but no luck, I'm afraid. I might have guessed you'd be the only one to find anything.
I wasn't expecting much to begin with. Eventually, there will be nothing left out here for us to safely salvage. For now, this will have to suffice. We should return to the station.
There you are. Heard you'd gone hunting for ceruleum above ground. Brought back a king's ransom?
Hardly. But thanks to these three, we have enough to last a little while longer.
Well, well. It's not at all what I was expecting, these ones. For savages, they seem positively docile. It's a poor attempt at humour. In all honesty, I'm grateful for your efforts. But even with another night of warmth, there are those among us who may not live to see the morrow.
I trust your expedition was fruitful.
Lord Quintus!
Use what you procured to refuel the armor.
But, sir, what about the heaters for the camp?
The time for action is upon us. My men and I have matters to discuss. In the meantime, you are to wait here. Do not forget, you are being watched.
The time for action. What did he mean by that?
I can only speculate. Clearly something requiring their magitech, given what we just heard. Whether they plan to utilize it now or after they join with the Tenth is another question. Escape this cold? Return to and reclaim the idyllic spaces of which Eulis spoke?
finished your war council?
Alfino and Alize are to stay here as our prisoners. They will be released once your comrades have relinquished their supplies and withdrawn from Garlean soil. Until our terms are met, they will be detained at a separate location.
After everything we've said and done, this is how you treat us.
Our allies have but limited supplies. They may stave off cold and starvation for a short while, but what then?
For now, keeping yourselves out of harm's way comes before all else. Whatever demands the Garleans make, indulge them.
Get them out of here.
Thank you.
This is my home. Our home. At least it was until that night. I was with Lord Quintus when the capital fell, and thus spared. My family, who did not own a radio, were less fortunate. When dawn came, I made my way here. My parents, my little brother and sister, they were still inside. But they weren't themselves, and they tried to. Promised to take them away from the capital that very morning, to somewhere safe, to hide until the fighting stopped. I promised. The Garlean flag bears a chain, the bonds between our countrymen. A red link at its center, the blood of the fallen. Our loved ones who lived and died for Garlemald. But if she too fell, who would be left to remember them and their sacrifice? What enduring proof would there be that they were ever here? If we had turned to your gods, would they have saved us? I'm sorry, forget I spoke. We should go.
No use.
Believe me, I do not enjoy being here any more than you. But he wanted us to play along, so that is what we will do.
So cold.
Painfully so. Unbearably.
I've been thinking about what Quintus said. About why no one would accept Garlean rule. Irreconcilable differences. When coexistence isn't an option, only conquest remains. Varys at Gimlet said much the same. Only by uniting the world beneath a single standard would we rid ourselves of the Ascians. United as one people, one race cleansed of imperfections. A cold and unforgiving vision. And when we fail to live up to their standards, what place is there for us in their world? But the truly sad, truly frustrating thing is how damnably similar it all is to the lofty ideals of Father and the Forum. Non-intervention. Always non-intervention. Protect our knowledge and our people, and to hell's with the rest of you. And yet, I can see how it happened. Varys and Father looked to their elders for guidance and took their virtues as their own. But for this world was of their making. In who else could they place their trust? All of us lost in a sea of chaos. searching desperately for purpose and meaning. But it shouldn't just be an extension of another's. It has to be ours. It has to be. We all have a stake in this world. No one should be silenced.
I won't deny that we lack the experience of people such as Father or Quintus. Perhaps they've come to see the world as a series of problems, and the most efficient way of solving them, to reduce everything to fundamental forms. A stone is a stone, a cloud, a flower, no more than that. Simple descriptions that strip the subject of distinguishing characteristics. A man is a man, divided according to race, creed, or allegiance, and to some, defined by such associations.
Is that what you think?
In my misbegotten youth, but what I believed wisdom was no more than aggressive ignorance. I've since learned to look beyond the banners and the politics, to see people as individuals with their own hopes and dreams. As for my dream of building a better world, well, every day I'm reminded that it is far more complex than I had ever imagined. But it only spurs me onward. Find the wisdom and the strength to see it through to the very end.
All of our supplies and an immediate withdrawal. These are your conditions.
Demands. And you forgot about the airship. Once again, you will leave one behind. It will be used to return the prisoners. Their collars will be removed prior to the exchange.
So in the end, not even Father's expertly worded rhetoric could deter you from your chosen course. Not that I thought for a moment that it would. I've no love for violence, of course, but ours is a cause worth fighting for. I just wish he'd realize it too. Sometimes the only way to protect the ones you love is to take a stand, to refuse to suffer in silence. I want you to know I share your conviction. Whether it be on the battlefield or in the debating chamber, I won't back down. I guess what I'm saying is...
You've found your own reason to fight.
Yes. Yes, I have. God's willing, there will come a day when we can finally lay down our arms, and there will be peace. But not until the Teloferoi have been defeated once and for all. And you, brother, will have a vital part to play. By your words and deeds, you'll lead the way.
I pray I am up to the task.
There'll always be naysayers. Those who think us fools for even trying. It's easy for learned elites to criticize earnest efforts and assert their moral superiority, all without offering alternatives. Not that their sophistry has ever wounded you. So stubborn and strong, stronger than you even know. Don't ever change, you hear me? If you stumble, I'll be there to catch you. Or give you a thick ear. Maybe both, for good measure.
Thank you, Alizé.
The scouts have secured Alizé and Alfino. Their collars were removed without complication as well. They report no casualties, not for their party nor the guards who will wake from their premature slumber in due course.
It would appear the situation has changed. I propose new terms. We have information that will be of great interest to Lord Quintus, and I wish to speak with him in person.
No. In the event you rejected our first proposal, we came prepared with a second.
Soldiers of the First Legion, proud servants of Garlemald, of the fallen Emperor Varys, shall safeguard these lands from the barbarian hordes until our countrymen return!
Stop, both of you!
This child may be the worst emissary I have ever seen.
We received an urgent communication from the Grand Company of Eorzea. Envoys from the Imperial Army, led by members of the 10th Legion, came to Alamigo and requested an audience. They explained that their efforts to coordinate the reclamation of the capital with the aid of the 4th, 5th, 8th, and 12th had ended in failure. Communication between most legions has broken down entirely. Most of the 10th's conscripts have deserted, leaving their forces severely depleted. That is why, unable to continue the fight on their own, they and their allies turned to the Grand Company of Eorzea for aid.
Lies! Every word!
It is the truth, and I have not finished. The 10th has requested that we deliver a message to Lord Quintus. Have the ill stand down.
You have been listening, my lord? What are your orders?
Inform her that we will honor the 10th's decision. Bereft of hope, and now dignity. I release you from your duty. All of you. I take solace, your radiance, in the knowledge you are not here to witness our debasement. 'Twas a grand, glorious dream we shared. Of a world united, of peace and prosperity. We are ghosts, you and I, memories of days gone by. Bonds forged in blood that I will not see tarnished.
Oh.
Quickly! We have to reach the station before it's too late.
If there is still a chance that Quintus will agree to a truce, we must take it.
I just hope we get there before he and his men do something rash.
Thank you. Thank you.